Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like to read more of this disclaimer, simply hit the pause key on your video player. Good afternoon. Ira Epstein of Linen Associates with your agriculture update for this Thursday, the 28th of September, 2017, and we're at 2:25 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Take a look at the grains, all of them down. We have a supply-demand report coming out tomorrow. It really should impact the wheat market, not the corn or the beans at this time of the year. It's where they make adjustments in the ending supplies with harvest and so on. We'll see what it does in the marketplace. Today you did get a bit of a correction happening in the dollar index, and most of the currencies are up today against, as you can see, the dollar. Stock market, well, the NASDAQ is down and the other markets have small gains. That's about all that you can say about them. The cotton market getting some short covering. Sugar market getting a little bit of a bid after the big break that it's had. And energy markets as a group are all down today. As we go to the soybeans on a weekly chart, you can see how the market still had that up thrust in place. And this is our first correction, and it did take out last week's low. So we have something of a trading top coming into place. Now the question is going to be yields. I know the sources that Linen Associates looks at, and we do a lot of hedging for farmers, and agriculture is one of the big businesses in this particular firm. They are hearing better yields in key areas than they thought. So we'll see if the market agrees with that when we see government reports coming out. When we look at a daily area chart of closes, you can see that the thrust of the market is clearly to the downside. When we go to a daily bar chart and just look at how the setup of the chart is, well, you've got something of a trading bottom here, just where? In the 936 area. You have a trading top now just over 984, and the market's meandering in the two, and you get to see how that plays out. Even though I said 36, the swing line's got higher lows, but then the break that you've just had this week carried through the last 63 low, so now you're out of a trend. You have a higher high and a lower low. That is not the definition of a trend. And the battleground is where we started talking about it 3 days ago, that if the market fell down, first support was the 18-day average, and as you can see, that is where the market went. Second support would be the number under it, the 100-day. It doesn't mean it has to stop there by any means. And of course, the battleground is, can it break away from that? And if it does, where might it head? And the answer to that is one of the potential spots is 952 3/4, the lower Bollinger Band. And the rationale there is Bollinger Bands act as theoretical resistance and support numbers. 95% of the time, the market's going to trade within the band. That's how the algorithm is built. So it'll adjust for that. I have come up with ideas as to how you can count each one of those days, and I often talk about them here. I do a lot more of that in my trading course, but suffice to say, it seems to be that the market's just going sideways right here, trying the upside, trying the downside, trying to figure out where to go. Momentum is measured by the slow stochastic oscillator, and it's a momentum index. I have no idea even what stochastics or slow means. How's that? And I was friends with the man that developed this. I started laughing at all these words, stochastics. But it's a momentum oscillator of two lines, the K and the D. One runs faster than the other. That's how to look at it. The red line whips around the dark line. And when they're both pointing down as they are, it means momentum is leading price typically. The theory of momentum oscillators is often that momentum will lead price. It's not a following indicator, it's leading price. And that seems to be what it is. Keep in the back of your mind that moving averages are typically following indicators. They don't lead the price. In the daily bar chart, the December soybean meal is on the verge of a problem right here. You have a market that had an outside day down. So one of two things happens. You either take out that high and you start moving again higher as a trap for the bears now. Why do I call it a trap? If you take out the high of an outside day down, it often catches a group of people and you hit stops or buying pressure above the market. If you don't take that out, the next support, since you're trading at the 100-day, could be 309.90. Here's the dilemma. If you take out 310.20 and you get to 309.90, two things.
First, you're going to switch the swing lines from pointing up to lower highs and then lower lows, and you'd be under the 18 average. It could be a change of trend, and the market might set up the 301.20 area. Let's assume that doesn't happen, and the market takes out today's high. Then maybe it can go up to the upper Bollinger Band with the trend still intact. It's going to be an important day as I see it tomorrow. One of the markets that has fallen apart has been soybean oil. And if we look at the soybean oil, we have a big succession of days that are now trading underneath the lower Bollinger Band. I think it's four in a row. The odds of it tomorrow closing under it are about 1%. That does not mean you have to rally. You could get sideways action with the Bollinger Band falling. We have to wait and see. Another event that's happened in soybean oil. The trend has gone to embedded. So it switched from oversold to embedded. Another element that happened. The reason that soybean oil was getting a big rally is there was a lot of talk a month ago, about the government shutting off certain supplies of oil from Indonesia and South America, one of the countries there, and the rationale being that they thought they were dumping it. Then we heard talk about changing the mix of biodiesels. Well, it got very confusing. At first it was bullish, now people don't think that's going to happen, and suddenly the big bid in the market has gone to an offer and meals worth more money on the crush than the soybean oil. It's one of the ways you think about it. Biodiesel is very important right now. In the corn market, the market is stuck. It's trying the upside, trying the downside. It's failing every which way it's going right now. And that's because it's caught in a narrow Bollinger Band. I'm going to call the trend down because you've got lower highs and lower lows. You're under the 18-day average. Momentum, though, is not going anywhere. It just stuck sideways. And as you can see, the market is failing against the 18-day average of closes. When we go to the wheat market, this has been a market that's been trying to go to the upside. I'm concerned that it's not able to push through the upper Bollinger Band. Bollinger Bands are that theoretical resistance or support areas, and look at how the market keeps failing against that number. The slow stochastic indicator is embedded bullish. It means both numbers are over 80, and frankly, until the red line closes under 80, I think the bulls have grabbed control of the market, even though they're at a big resistance zone, and on breaks they keep buying it until that is lost. When it's lost, there may not be much to gain. Why? Because the objective is the 18-day average of closes, and you're not far from it. This is a son of a gun to trade right now. In the sugar market, you have a pattern, I'm in the March sugar now, of a higher high and a lower low. Now we're watching the sugar millers in Brazil crushing a lot more cane for sugar because of the price of ethanol, what's going on there, and the rains there have been good enough so that the crops, first we were worried about how they were doing, they're doing better. So the market's been under selling pressure, but it is oversold. It had an inside day today, which is often a sign of a pause. You were coming into today 2 days under the lower Bollinger Band. You move to the right-hand side. So I just showed you a market in soybean oil four under. You don't have to rally much to solve that. Sometimes you do. But the key is if you sold yesterday hoping you were getting a decline, problem for you right now. In the coffee market, lower highs, lower lows, this market just fell out of bed. There's no other way to say it. You're here in the 147 area, and before you know it, this market is down to 131. It's just bang, it fell apart. And you can see, just continually going down. Now you're into the oversold area. Can you make it to the lower Bollinger Band? Don't know. You're already oversold. In the cocoa market, look at the number that you're failing at on the chart, the upper Bollinger Band. That's very problematic. Number two, momentum is starting to lead price to the downside. It crossed over now. If this market gets under 1960, you could end up with the pattern of lower highs, lower lows. If you close under the 18-day average, you'd have bias down and momentum down. So this market is fighting now to not get under 1960. I'm not saying it can't get there and spin back up, but I'm saying what the chart action is, and that's the events that I'm seeing. In the cotton market, suddenly the market's got a different nature about it. I always get concerned when I see a pattern of higher lows, lower highs. It's a cause of concern. The reigning momentum of this market is to the downside because the stochastics are locked in and embedded. I wouldn't be surprised to get a rally here and see that this market decides at that point on a rally, is it going to keep the embedded reading? If it gets up over 20, the odds are you're going to come up here. If the market goes higher and then back through 68.18, then the bear trend resumes, in my opinion. In the cattle market, you have a pattern of higher lows, higher highs. The resistance right now is the 100-day average. So on the way up, it sliced through that like it didn't exist. You see that? Then it fell back, and all of a sudden, it's hugging that number again. Momentum has been working itself off in a condition where the market is no longer in overbought area. In the feeder cattle market, you have a higher high and a lower low, market slipping a little bit. In the hog market, you had a pig crop report just come out. I know our firm's analyzing it now, but we're not looking for much change. The problem that we've been looking at in hogs that has been bothersome to us is that the cash market and the futures markets are far apart. The futures are about an $8 premium to the cash market in the front end of the October contract. Does it belong that much with this pig crop report that came out? I think that's going to be one of the things that we start looking at. For the back end of the market, this report, well, now we'll see if the front end premium of $8, how the trade looks at it, and that'll be tomorrow. So be very ready for that. The report's out, but the reaction will set in the morning. I want to remind you about research. Here we just talked about a pig crop report. We cover all this in detail. Tonight, our customers, our research department is already writing in-depth reports on this, the analysis, what they think that the speculators are going to do, what the hedgers will do, option trades on it, so on and so forth, through all the markets. If you'd like to get a free copy of our research for a limited period, you can give us a call at this number. Go to IraEpstein.com, www.IraEpstein.com. You can click up here if you're watching me on YouTube, and underneath us on many websites, it says click here for Ira's free offers. Do so. We'll put it in your hands. I'm Ira Epstein. You have a great day, and I'll talk to you tomorrow.